Good morning, all of you. So let's get started with today's class. I'll just quickly go over a couple of slides that we had in the previous class and move on to today's class. In the previous class, we started with the properties of proportion at similar polygon. We saw the cross product property that if A over B equals C over D, then we can say that AD equals BC. We also saw a reciprocal property, if A over B equals C over D, then B over A equals D over C. We saw another reciprocal property that if A over B equals C over D, then A over C is also equal to B over D. And the third reciprocal property that we saw was, if A over B equals C over D, then A plus B over B will be equal to C plus D over D. We saw these three reciprocal properties, and we also saw this particular slide about the definition of when the two figures can be said to be similar. The two geometric figures are similar if their corresponding angles are congruent and their corresponding segment lengths are proportional. So all the segment lengths have to be proportional in the two figures, and all the angles have to be, the corresponding angles have to be congruent, then we can say two figures are similar. If a rectangle ABCD and rectangle EFGH are similar, write four different proportions and solve for x. That's what we had done this particular problem. Angles A is congruent to E, B is congruent to F, C is congruent to G, D was congruent to H. Then we set AB equals EF, BC equals FG, and CD equals GH, and AD equals EH. Those were the four sides, and we equated and then solved for X. The solution is available in the previous video lesson, and it should be there on the hub. You can check for the solution. Let's get started with the next slide. Okay. Triangle BCD is similar to triangle ACE. Set up and solve the proportion to find BC. Okay, set up the proportion and solve for BC. I'll give you exactly like a minute or so, then you can just tell me what is the value of BC. Okay, try to set up the proportion. So first use the chat to tell me what is the proportion, and then I want you all to tell me what is the answer for BC as well. So you have a minute from now, and I want active participation from all of you on this particular problem. Okay, just use your chat. Okay. There are several ways that this particular problem can be set up. So one of the ways is this. We can just call this particular BC as X, and I can call this as X over 12 equals 24 over 18. X over 12. X is the corresponding side for the X, the corresponding X over 12. For X, the corresponding side is 24, and for 12, the corresponding side is 18. You can do it in this manner. You'll get the solution of X. Or you can also do it by comparing with the for the triangle. There are two similar triangles. We haven't got to a, we have to learn one of the theorem or property which will come in future classes, where you can exactly say that whenever you have two similar triangles which are in this particular fashion, you can directly say that BC over CA minus, actually what are we writing here? BC over CA minus AB equals CD over, at corresponding to CD I have the side same as CA minus AB. CA was the larger one. For CD, the corresponding side is CE, and for same way here, instead of AB, I should have DE, CE minus DE. That's what we are doing to get this particular proportion, and then we are solving for x. So, and if we further solve, you'll get x as cross multiply this 24 times 12 divided by 18. That gives us x equals 60. Okay. But from the proportion that we had learned, we did not have this minus, we had plus. Okay. We had learned one of the reciprocal properties with plus. So imagine that you are adding a negative line segment. Imagine that you are adding a negative line segment. There's a small error here. Instead of AB, it should be CB, right? CA minus CB. So this both will change. But CA minus CB will give us 12, and same way CE minus CD will give us 18. Okay. We had learned a reciprocal property where we had added in the previous slide, we saw this here in the reciprocal property. Whenever we have proportion of this sort, we can add, we thought. And here we are having something of that similar type with using couple of properties at theorem also. We have BC over CA minus CB equals CD over CE minus CD, and then we are solving x equals 60. Okay. But if we were to solve this based on whatever we just have, whatever we just learned, we don't have actually one of the theorem or property, then we should have done in the manner that I'm solving below. Okay, we just have only two similar triangles, and we know the property that corresponding to CB, the side corresponding to CB is CA. CB over CA should be equal to CD over CE. Okay, but this setup would have made it little more complicated for us to solve, but we'll try. So CB was what? CB was x, and CA was x plus 12. Will be equal to 24 over 24 plus 18. This should have been the correct way based on our property of similar triangle, that simplest property. The corresponding side of CB is CA. Corresponding side of CD is C. That's all I'm taking. I'm not adding or subtracting or anything of the sides. And then you cross multiply. So first 24 plus 18 is nothing but 42. So 42 times x. So 42x equals 24 times of x plus 12. So that gives us 24x, and 24 times 12 gives us 288. Subtract 24x from both these sides to get 18x equals 288. And further divide by 18 on both the sides to get x as 60. So even in this method, you'll get the same answer. Okay. I was just expecting you all to use this method because we were only having that particular similarity based on the definition of similar polygons. This might be a little lengthier, but it gives the same answer. Okay. Let's see the next slide. All of the triangles in the figure below are similar. Set up and solve the proportion to find AB and GF. Okay. You have like a couple of minutes. So you're supposed to solve AB and GF. Let me call this AB as X and GF as Y. You have a minute or couple of minutes to solve this. Based on your answers, so I had the proportion that your class suggested proportion here. x is to 35 equals 24 is to y. And equals further, I have 18 is to 21, right? This is what most of you suggested. We will check this. To solve for x, I have to use this and this. Just a. Okay, to solve for x, I have to use x over 35 equals 18 over 21. Just cross multiply. So you'll have 21x equals 35 times 18. And 35 times 18 is nothing but 630. And divided by 21 gives us 30. So I have x equals 30. Absolutely right. As all of you had this one. Same way, to solve for y, we have to use the second and the third, that is 24 is to y equals 18 is to 21. Once again, cross multiply, you will have 21 times 24 equals 18 times y. Dividing by 18, first multiply 21 times 24 divided by 18 gives us y equals 28. Okay. Which majority if you had? Let's see the next slide. We will see some more things about similar polygons here. Two polygons are similar if the corresponding angles are congruent and all the corresponding lengths are proportional. That's the definition of similar polygon. The symbol used for similarity is a tilted S. It's like this. Okay. In the diagram below, triangle CDG is similar to triangle CEF. So what all can we say? We can say that angle C is congruent to angle C, angle D is congruent to angle E, and we can also say that angle G is congruent to angle F. And for proportionalities, we can say that CD over corresponding to CD, the side which is proportional to that particular side in the larger triangle is CE. CD is to CE will be equal to, same way we will have DG is to EF and CG is to CF. Okay. Let's see the next slide. In the diagram, triangle ABC is similar to triangle DF. List all the pairs of congruent angle. Check that ratios of the corresponding lengths are equal. Write the ratios of corresponding side lengths in a statement of proportionality. Okay, once again, I'll give you like 2 minutes. Use your chat and try to answer this particular problem A, B, and C. So your answer in the chat should have A, B, and C parts. You have 2 minutes. List all pairs of congruent angle. Check that ratios of the corresponding side lengths are equal. You say yes or no here, and here you tell the statement of proportionality. Okay, as you all said, the A here in terms of just single letter, if you have to say, angle A is congruent to angle angle D, comma angle B is congruent to angle E, and angle C is congruent to angle F. Okay, this was the answer for A part. We can also say for this one the answer as angle BAC is congruent to EDF and ABC is congruent to DEF, BCA is congruent to EFD. Okay, there are two ways that we can name an angle, so we can use any of them. Check that the ratios of the lengths are equal. For that, corresponding length. So I have AB is to DE. I should have AB is to DE should be equal to BC is to EF, and this should in turn be equal as AC is equal to DF. So we have to check if this is true. AB over DE is nothing but I have 16 over 24 should be equal to BC is nothing but 8 and EF is 12 and AC is 12 and DF is 18. So we have 16 divided by 24, which is 0.6667, and same way 8 divided by 12 gives us same thing, 0.6667. it's repetitive 6 and 7, and 12 divided by 18, once again we have the same value. So therefore we have the, it's repetitive at 7. We can conclude, or if you are rounding up to third decimal, we usually round to third decimal, it's going to be 0.667 to thousands if I round. So for B, yes, check the ratios of the corresponding side lengths are equal, so you will say yes. Okay, and actually the ratio should have been this one. Write the ratio of the corresponding side lengths in a statement of proportionality. So we should have just written this one. AB is to DE equals BC is to EF equals AC is to DF. Or you can just write even it this pattern. And further we can just simplify it to most simplified form. Here I have it, all of them are nothing but 2 over 3. If you just simplify, you can make out that all these 3 will end up being 2 is to 3. So I'll have to write 2 over 3. So the ratio is going to be 2 is to 3.